I will try to justify the reputation here. It is not very easy, but I will try. The point I was asked to speak to you today is leadership. The whole week is dedicated to leadership. How does the Jewish outlook about Jews, about leadership, what means a leader in the eyes of Judaism? A prophet, a rabbi, a king, a judge, a fighter, a statesman? Who is a leader in the eyes of the Jewish concept? And we are blessed with very, very many leaders of all kinds during the history of 3,400 years. Avraham Avinu, a leader. Moshe Rabbeinu, Yoshua Ben Nun, King David, King Saul, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, all the other prophets, Mordechai ve Esther, Matityahu, Judah the Maccabee, leaders, Hagaon Mivilna, Baal Shem Tov, leaders, Rav Kook, leaders, and everyone in his stream, and everyone in his field, and some of them in many, many fields, who and what is a leader in the Jewish eyes. Let's give the world to the giant of all the leaders. I believe so. Not only in the Jewish world, in mankind, universally. No one can compete the place of Moshe, Moshe Rabbeinu. This is the leader. He has all these qualifications I have mentioned and many more. On one side, Lo kam od navi beYisrael keMoshe. No one was a prophet in the same level like Moshe Rabbeinu. The Lord Almighty speaks to him 40 years, face to face, the only one. The only one. Asher yeda'o Hashem. The Lord knew him, panim el panim, face to face. So Navi, a prophet, to see the future, only him. Nobody like him, Navi. He gave us the Torah. A week from now, Matan Torah, he's Rabbeinu, our rabbi. He's the first rabbi of the people of Israel. He gave the whole Torah. A rabbi. He gave the laws. He's the Supreme Court. He's the president of the Supreme Court for many, many years. Mechokek. Torah. Navi. What a statesman. To come to Pharaoh, where he escaped from Pharaoh some years before, found a shelter in Midian by his father-in-law, Yitro, escaped from Pharaoh. He comes into the palace, to the face of the king, who is looking after him. He's wanted in Egypt for a murder. He comes in and said, Ko amar Hashem Elokei Israel. The Lord, the God of the Jewish people, said, Shalach et ami ve'yavduni. Let my people go and they have to serve me in the desert. Who are you? In whose name do you speak about? Shalach et ami. The first one who brought out from slavery to freedom a nation, a whole nation, who was created by this Exodus. Can you compare it to Spartacus? To Bolivar, to Garibaldi, Mandela, maybe Lincoln. Moshe was the first and the greatest to take out a whole nation from being slaves four generations. And then in the desert, 40 years, to supply food. He gives food. He's the minister of economy. Daily food, man, meat, slav, the well of water later, in privilege of his sister Miriam. Be'er, mayim, slav, man, daily, 40 years. And the fighter against Sichon Melech Haemori, against Og Melech HaBashan, Beyadcha Natati Oto. God said to him, in your hands he will fall. These two giants, the kings, Sichon and Og, in your hands. Show me one man who has all these qualifications together in one personality. The prophet, the rabbi, the judge, Miboker ad Erev, judging the people, the supplier of food, the fighter to defend all the people, and to bring the Torah and to teach it. One person. Now let ask him, Moshe, what is your opinion? You have to speak now in Toledo for Olami. They asked me to describe what means a leader, what means leadership in the eyes of Judaism. You are the expert. You are the founder. Please, give us a lesson. What is in your eyes a leader? So let's give the word now. Let's give the microphone to Moshe. Think about it. Moshe gives us a short lesson. What is leadership in his very eyes? He is the address, the best. Many times in the Torah you find the sentence, Vayedaber Hashem el Moshe Lemor. God spoke to Moshe, telling him this and that. Daber el Bnei Yisrael, Daber el Aharon vel Banav, do this, do yet. The only place in the book of Bamidbar, chapter 27, just the contrary. Vayedaber Moshe el Hashem Lemor. Moshe spoke to God. Lemor, tell me. Lemor, speak to me. Give me an answer. What do you want? What is your question? What is your problem? Vayedaber Moshe el Hashem Lemor. What do you ask me to do or to say? Lemor, to say. We need a leader to replace me. You told me that I am not crossing the Jordan. You told me that I have to die here in the desert or in Moab, in Har Nevo. You told me that I am punished not to see Eretz Yisrael, to see, yes, but not to cross the Jordan. So they need a shepherd. They need a leader. Yifkod Hashem Elokei Haruchot Lechol Basar Ish Alaida. They need a leader on the whole tribe. Elokei Haruchot Lechol Basar. What an expression. You know the thoughts of everyone, the minds of everyone. You know the characters of everyone, how split they are among themselves. They need someone to make them a nation. And this is my concern. I don't speak about my last will. I have no properties. I am not going to divide anything because I have nothing. I don't need anything. I need one thing, and this bothers me in my last words nowadays. You told me that I am not crossing the Jordan. Okay. All my prayers didn't work. I have only one request, to take care for my people. How? To say who can replace me as their leader. Asher lo tihye adat Hashem, katzon asher ein lahem ro'eh. They cannot be like the animals without a shepherd. They need a shepherd. And who is a shepherd? Who is qualified to be a shepherd? Moshe says, not someone who knows the whole Bible by heart, not someone who knows the Talmud, Bavli or Yerushalmi before it was created, no one who is in the Maimonides' shoes, no. No one who has a high IQ, no one who is very intelligent, no one who speaks many languages, no. Who is the guy? Not one, the strong one, with the muscles of Hercules, no. Not a fighter, no. One thing I need. Asher yeitze lifnehem, v'asher yavo lifnehem. The leader must be someone who gives a personal example. Dugma ishit in Hebrew. When they go to the army, to the battlefield, he has to be the first one. Yeitze lifnehem. And they come back, they finish the war, the battlefield. Yavo lifnehem. He has to be with them. Not like all the other kings who sit in their palaces, Rashi brings it, and he's sending his people, go. Not to say go, but to say follow me. Follow me. I give you the example. I will be the pioneer. You have to follow me. I need Moshe says. Moshe, after all his experiences, 40 years leading the Jewish people, said one thing that we need. A leader who gives a personal example, who is ready to sacrifice himself for his people, to sacrifice himself. I remember about 60 years ago, a speech in Petah Tikva, in a secondary school called Brenner, Tichon Brenner. In the last class, children of 18 years old, boys and girls, and I asked them, who is the first one in the Jewish history who have built the slogan, Acharai, follow me. Not Kadima, not Goa. Follow me, Acharai. Someone said, Arik Sharon. He was the leader of a paratroopers group of fighters, real fighters, 101. And then Arik Sharon said, he was, but not the first one. The other one said, Ord Wingate, if you know the history of Palestine before Israel. He wanted to build a Jewish army in the time of the British mandate. Colonel Ord Wingate, Jew. No, Wingate, Arik Sharon, Kol HaKavod. Who was the first to say, Acharai, follow me? None answered the real answer, Moshe Rabbeinu. The first one to say, Acharai. Give a personal example. This is not only in the battlefield, in the army. Acharai means in all the aspects of life. This means Acharai. Take from me an example and follow me. That's what we say in the Mishnah in Avot. We started now to speak about Pirkei Avot. Yesterday was dedicated the lesson after 527 years, Jews in Toledo, speaking about Avot. Ezehu Chacham, Ezehu Ashir, Ezehu Gibor, Ezehu Mechubad, Ben Zoma. In Masechet Avot, you find the expression very often. Hu haya omer. We translate it, he was used to say. He said it, he repeated it many, many times. Hu haya omer. In the Hasidic movement, Baal Shem Tov and his followers, they say, no. Hu haya. First of all, he, the scholar, he was himself. And then Omer, then he used to say to the others. But first of all, because before he told the others what to do and how to behave, Hu haya. He was the personal example. He was it. He did it. He behaved like this. And this gave him the power, the moral and the ethic power to be Omer, to say the others, follow me, Acharai. Hu haya Omer. And if you want the Rav of Lublin, Lublin in Poland today, Rabbi Meir Shapira, who founded the idea of Daf Hayomi, he explained the first, the title of the sixth chapter of Avot, Kinyan Torah, Shanu Chachamim b'leshon ha-Mishnah, Tanu Rabbanan, in the text of this Mishnah, Baruch Shebachar Bahem Uve Mishnatam. Same thing. Look at these words. Blessed are you, Ribono Shel Olam, God in heaven, that you have chosen them and they're teaching us. Baruch Shebachar Bahem, first of all, look who they were. Who they are. Look at their personalities. Who says, Hevei ohev shalom, verodef shalom, ohev et abriyot umekarvan haTorah? Who? Aaron gave it, the example. But who said it in the Mishnah? Hillel Omer. Hillel Omer, Hevei be one of the students of Mitalmidav shel Aaron, ohev shalom, verodef shalom. It suits him. Exactly. This was the person. Ohev et abriyot. Ohev shalom. Rodef shalom. Hillel may say it because he gave the example. He gave the how to behave like this. He didn't say the others, what he didn't do. So Baruch Shebachar Bahem first and then Bemishnatam, what they said. In the Hebrew University, in Jerusalem, before the establishment of the Jewish state, means over 71 years, there was a professor, doctor maybe, young professor, who taught the ethics and the morals of religions, such as Christianity, Islam, many religions from the Far East. He spoke about philosophy, of an ethics of religions, including, of course, the Jewish religion. A group of students came to the president of the university at the time, I will not mention names, with a complaint. This young professor who teaches us ethics and morals, he is in his behavior, in his personality, just the contrary of all what he is speaking about. And they mentioned some of his expressions, of his behavior. He doesn't fit. It cannot be that he will be, for us, a teacher of morals and ethics. He is the contrary of all of them. All what he is speaking about. The president had to defend his young professor. He said to them, what has it to do what he is teaching about and how he behaves about? There's no contact. For example, I am, as you know, a professor of mathematics. Will someone ask me to be a ruler? No, I'm a professor of rulers. I can teach you geometria and trigonometria and stereometria, all kinds of mathematics. I myself, something different. That's what he wanted to defend the young professor, but it's not true. Judaism asks and demands the leader. You speak about ethics, give an example, personal example. You speak about moral, be like this. You cannot separate the personality of the teacher, the educator, not only teacher, the one who has to educate us, to bring us up, and his own personality, different than all of it, it doesn't work. It doesn't fit itself. Must be Hu Haya Omer. That's what Moshe Rabbeinu, the only place where he applies to the God and said, you know them. Elokei haruchot lechol basar. You know all the winds blowing from time to time, from one side to the other. You know all the people. Please choose one asher yeitze lifnehem v'asher yavo lifnehem. The one who will not say, go ahead. The one who will say, follow me. Take from me a personal example. This is the main point of leadership in Jewish eyes. Before you pretend to be a leader, show who you are, how do you behave, and if we can follow you, yes or not. This is number one. Number two, if you ask what is Judaism outlook about leadership, I don't bring you a quotation from the end of Moshe Rabbeinu, what I brought just now, but from the very beginning. The first meeting with the God was in the desert, Sinai desert, and he saw the bush burning in fire, the flames, and it still exists. The bush is not liquidated. A small bush, dry, in the desert, in the heat, burning in fire, and he exists, and he survives. Asura navere, I must go and see closer, nearer. Madua lo yivarasne, how can it be that the bush is still exist? The Almighty appeared to him from the burning bush, said to him, Anochi Elokei Avicha, I am your father's God, Elokei Avraham, Yitzchak v'Yaakov, and I have a mission for you. Go to Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Lecha v'shlachacha el Paro melech Mitzrayim. V'hotze et ami b'nei Yisrael me'eretz Mitzrayim. And bring out my people from the land of Egypt. You are the man. Moshe said, I'm a shepherd of animals, not of human beings. The animals who belong to my father-in-law. And Ro'etzon, son Yitro, Kohen Midian. How do you ask me such a mission to do? How can I do it? Mi Anochi, who am I? Ki elech el paro v'chi otzi el b'nei Yisrael me'eretz Mitzrayim. How can I do it? I have no language. I'm not a statesman. I'm not a diplomat. I'm not a leader. I'm not a politician. I'm a shepherd. And someone who escaped from Egypt, I will not mention that maybe I'm in a danger to enter to the borders of Egypt. I don't speak about my old sacrificing. I speak about my qualifications. I am not the man for this. And God answered to him, Ki eheye imach, veze lecha haot ki anochi shlachticha. You see this burning bush? According to all the rules of nature, he had to be liquidated the first moment. And he exists. It exists because I'm here. I want it. Nothing will happen to you bad. Don't worry. I'm with you. All the talents, all the way how to speak, what to say, I'm with you. It's a good answer. Then he asks other questions. I'm not used to speak. I have no experience. And the people of Israel will not believe me. They will not trust me. They will say, Ah, lo nira elech Hashem. It cannot be. From all the people of Israel, he didn't have one to choose to lead us. But you, who are you? We don't know you. Even with the old people in Egypt who remember you from here, they remember you growing up in the palace of Pharaoh, of the knees of the ruler, of the knees of the dictator. Maybe you come to test us, to test our loyalty to the king. We don't trust you. And he gives five times objections why he doesn't want to go. And the last one, and I want you to pay attention to the last words of Moshe in that occasion. Shlachna b'yad tishlach. Send by whom you are used to send. What? I answered you all the questions one after the other, 5 times. And I gave you all the equipment, how to do. After all of it, you say, I don't want to go. Send by someone else. Shlach nabiyat shlach. This is a way of negotiation. This is an excuse. Tell me why. Whatever you saw, I answered you. What means shlach nabiyat shlach? And by whom? By whom? Everyone doesn't understand. And the Lord Almighty was angry with these words. Vayichar af Hashem b'Moshe. I answered you everything in 2 chapters in the book of Exodus, chapter 3 and chapter 4. This is in chapter 4 already. What means you sent me to choose another one? I chose you. Our sages understood these words of Moshe, and I want you to feel it. Moshe said to him, Ribono shel Olam, I have to you a theoretical question. Who is closer to a man, to a human being? His nephew or his grandson? Ben Achiv, his nephew, or Ben Beno, his grandson? It's a theoretical question, because everyone gives the answer. Ben Beno. A grandson sitting on the knees of his grandfather. The grandfather has an ear to whom to tell about his experiences in life, because the elderly people don't want to listen to the old one. But the child is listening. He has patience, sabah. Grandfather, what do you say? Nephew? Okay. When he has bar mitzvah, I give him a nice present. Hanukkah, I give him some coins. Birthday, I give him also a present. Every birthday. But no more. My brother's son? Okay. But my son's son? Sometimes he's closer to me than my own son. My enik, my grandchild. If this is the answer, Moshe Rabbeinu says, according to the sages, it happens once that the nephew of Avraham Avinu, Lot, was in a danger, was in a trouble, in Sodom. When he came to destroy Sodom, you saved Lot and his family out of the fire, out of the destruction, and you let him live, to live. Whom did you send to save Lot because in privilege of his uncle Avraham Avinu? Vayavou shnei hamalachim sdoma ba'erev. 2 angels came from heaven in the evening to Sodom. The book of Genesis, chapter 19. Why 2 angels? 1 angel had to destroy the city of Sodom, and the second angel was sent to save out from the flames Lot. To save the nephew of Abraham, Ribono shel Olam, you sent an angel. And to save out from Egypt the whole Eniklach, the grandchildren of Abraham and Yitzchak and Yaakov, you didn't find another one to send but me, a shepherd of Yitro. I'm not an angel. I'm not sent from heaven. I come from Midian with some cows and gooses. I'm a shepherd. Shlachna, send beyat tishlach. Send with those who are you are used to send. And in experience, I know the history. You sent over an angel to save Lot. All my people, their sufferings in Egypt are less than Lot. With a final solution given then already, not by Hitler, by Pharaoh. Throw all the boys who are born just when they are born into the Nile. Havanit Chakmalo Penirbe. Let's find a way not to give the Jewish people to flourish and to multiply. In this situation, they need an angel at least to save them, their lives, not only slavery. And you sent me. Who am I? What am I? Shlachna v'yatishna. This was the last and the strongest complaint of Moshe. What do you see here? That a leader, really a leader, needs not only to give an example, a personal example, but he needs also two things. To love his people. To love and to be modest, anav, v'ha'ish Moshe anav me'od, mikol ha'adam asher al pnei adama. Moshe is the example of a modest one, not a careerist, not one who hates his people and it's only his own interest. He has no interest at all. He gives up everything. He loves his people. He is ready to sacrifice himself when he saw a Jew suffering from a non-Jew, a policeman, a capo, whatever, a Gestapo in Egypt. He, the prince of Egypt, who grew up in the palace of Pharaoh, he saved the life of a Jew, sacrificing himself in order to save the life of a stranger, but his brother. To look at your people as they are your brothers or your children. To love them and to be ready to sacrifice all your interests, including life, for them. These are, I think, the three qualifications needed from a leader in the Jewish concept. A personal example, to love your people, otherwise they feel that you are not the real leader. And third of all, to do all what you do with no pride, personal pride, no looking for compliments, no looking for a career. You can make your career, but in the way that your eyes and your minds and your heart is dedicated to your people. You are the shepherd. You are not the crown. They will give you the crown. They will give you, but you will not take it by yourself. A leader in the Jewish people is the one who haya omer. First of all, be what you have to be. Be a personality. And then tell us what to do and how to do, and how to behave. And I want to conclude, because it's Friday today, before you are going to light the candles of Shabbat, I want to say one word. We are under the umbrella of Olami. We speak about Keruv, 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 Keruv. I gave you some of the obligations on the shoulders of Moshe Rabbeinu. How did he stay in the history, in mankind's history maybe, but in Jewish history of course, Moshe HaNavi, you know Eliyahu HaNavi, but Moshe was the greatest Navi, why not Moshe HaNavi? Moshe HaMechokek gave us the laws, Moshe HaShofet, the judge, Shofet Etami Boker Aderev, Moshe HaMashbir, he gave us food. Moshe Halochem, a general, al tira oto ki biyadcha natati oto Sichon Melech Amori and Og Melech Abashan. So many titles for Moshe Rabbeinu. And how do we call him? How do we remember him? How do we remind him for the next generations? Not Moshe Hanavi, velo HaMechokek, velo HaShofet, velo HaMashbir, velo HaLochem. Rabbeinu. He is our rabbi. He taught us the Torah. This is the main point. This is the main thing. From all the deeds, from all the accomplishments of Moshe, number one is forever Rabbeinu. He is our rabbi. And if he is our rabbi, let's try to be his students.